Fraud detection is crucial for payment systems, but SQL-based implementations often lead to convoluted and hard-to-maintain code, like this, that, or even worse. I'm Matthew, and today I will show you how Nussknacker simplifies building fraud detection rules, making them straightforward and accessible for your team. We will tackle four common fraud detection rules: velocity, location, time patterns, and split transactions. These are essential building blocks of any robust anti-fraud system. We will apply these rules to a stream of events consisting of client ID, transaction amount, and location data in latitude and longitude format. For the velocity rule, we will identify transactions occurring too frequently within a short time. For the location rule, we will detect transactions coming from places too far apart in a short period. The time pattern rule will flag high-value transactions during unusual hours, and the split transaction rule will catch artificially split transactions designed to bypass limits. While SQL can express these rules, its complexity grows rapidly. Maintaining such logic and adapting it to new requirements becomes a serious challenge, especially when revisiting the rules after some time. Now, let's implement these rules in Nussknacker. First, let's add a source node to connect to a Kafka topic, providing real-time transaction data. Next, we will use a split node to divide the process into four parallel flows, one for each rule. Starting with the velocity rule, we will aggregate transactions over a 5-minute window using an aggregation node. This will calculate the transaction volume and total amount for each client thanks for grouping by client ID. It's a key step for detecting velocity fraud, where transactions from the same client exceed a threshold in a short period. After aggregating the data, we will use two filter nodes, one for transaction counts exceeding 5 and another for total amounts over 20,000. Separating these conditions improves readability and allows us to track event flow using Nussknacker's counts feature. Finally, a sync node will send filtered data to a knowledge topic, including the client ID and a description of the violation, ensuring flagged transactions are sent for immediate investigation. Next, we will detect geolocation anomalies. Using the previous value component, we will store the last known location and timestamp for each client, which would allow us to calculate their travel speed. To make this calculation clear, we will split it into three nodes. First, a node which calculates the distance in kilometers between the last known location and the current one, leveraging Nussknacker's built-in geospatial functions. Next, a node which computes the total time in hours between the two events. Finally, we calculate the client speed and check if it exceeds 500 km per hour. Suspicious events are routed to geolocation anomaly output sync, which sends alerts to our Kafka topic for further investigation. For the time pattern rule, we will add a filter node to detect transactions occurring between 1 a.m. and 5 a.m. Since high-value transactions during these hours are unusual, we will filter out only those exceeding certain threshold and send any flagged events to an alert sync, just as we did earlier. Lastly, let's address split transaction fraud. We start with an aggregation node to calculate the count, maximum amount, average amount, and total amount of transactions in a 15-minute window. Next, we filter aggregations with more than 5 transactions. Then, we apply additional filters, one for transactions where the maximum amount is less than 2,000, another for total amounts greater than 10,000, and finally, a filter to detect suspiciously uniform average transaction sizes. After applying all these filters, flagged transactions are sent to an alert sync. Once we've created these rules, we can bring them to life with a single click of the deploy button. After deployment, we can enable the counts feature, which provides immediate feedback on how many events pass through each node, helping us evaluate rules' performance. Unlike SQL, which can be hard to read and maintain, Nussknacker workflows are intuitive and self-explanatory. When business needs change, your team can update rules on the fly. For instance, we can very easily change the threshold for high-value transactions with just a few clicks. Once updated, the scenario can be redeployed immediately. With Nussknacker, you don't need to rewrite complex SQL queries. Making adjustment is fast and straightforward. Additionally, Nussknacker keeps track of the change history, allowing you to verify who made changes and how they were introduced to the scenario. And that's it for today's video. If you'd like to see more examples of how Nussknacker can simplify fraud detection and other real-time data challenges, make sure to subscribe and stay tuned for future videos. Thanks for watching. If you have any questions or want to share your thoughts, leave them in the comments below. And if you found this video helpful, don't forget to like and subscribe for more content on Nussknacker and stream-based data processing. Bye!